going on, YouTube? Welcome back to Sig's Kitchen. I'm Big Sig, and today we are making something true and dear to my heart, pizza. Today we're going to do a meat lovers for fat people like me, and we're going to do a veggie pizza for the people that don't eat the food that my food eats, like my sister. So I hope you're ready. Let's get to work. Ingredients: meat, my meat, hot sausage, pepperoni, sweet ham, bacon, garlic, olives, onion, pepper, basil, oregano, salt, pepper, whole tomatoes, tomato paste, mushrooms, and a three cheese blend. Asiago, mozzarella, grated pecorino romano, dodo, and beer. So the first thing we're gonna do for this meat lovers pizza is we're gonna cook up this bacon. Then we're gonna take it out of the pan, put it on another plate. We're gonna cook our sausage in that bacon fat because you know you gotta have the bacon fat. Then we're gonna take the ham and we're gonna cook that in the sausage and bacon fat, and all that fat's gonna come together and we're gonna get so fat, it's gonna be amazing. I hope you're ready for it. We're gonna drink beer in the meantime. Get ready. Sounds of sizzle. So now that our bacon is finished baking, we have a slotted spoon. We are just gonna scoop them out, drain the excess grease, transfer to a paper towel to dry, just like my dry jokes. So now we're gonna take our sausage and we're gonna go right into that, oh yeah, bacon fat. You wanna break it up nice. We're gonna make little meat de boiler looking thingies. This pizza's gonna be full of fat with a pH. So now that the sausage is done, we just cracked another cold one. Remember, stay hydrated. It gets hot in the kitchen. We're gonna transfer that meat to also dry on another plate. And then after that, we about to go ham. All right, we're going in. This is sweet ham because we have our salty bacon, we have our hot sausage, and we have sweet ham because you can't have the sweet without the heat and the salt to knock it out. So our ham is now done cooking in the fat of the fat to the fat. We're going to take that beautiful ham, drain it on a paper towel, just like the rest of it. And then we're gonna go and we're gonna make the best homemade pizza sauce you've ever tasted. It probably won't be, but I'm gonna tell you that so you make it anyway. All right, let's get saucy. I don't mean from drinking, I mean by making sauce. So let's start. We're gonna be using whole tomatoes from Italy. In the can, magically open, just like that. Right in. Beautiful, whole tomatoes. In, garlic, in. Tomato paste as a thickening agent. In, salt. In. Some fresh cracked pep. This is gonna put some pep in the step. In, we're gonna take some fresh oregano. It's not really fresh, it's dried. You get what I'm getting at here. And then we're gonna take some basil. Basil. We're gonna throw that in there. Then, the magic. A little bit of olive oil. Kill it with kindness. Boom. And we're gonna put the top on. I almost forget the most important ingredient. Beer, in, go. We may have had a malfunction. Let's check it. Don't worry about that little bit there. That little guy? Don't worry about that little guy. Let's see what we're looking at. Gonna put a little more tomato paste. We're gonna thicken her up. Make it, right, Paisan? More, more is less. Take a spoon. Need salt. Sauce. Bowl. Hey, give me some sugar. No, babe, not you. I need it for the sauce. If your pizza sauce is a little bit acidy, a little bit of white sugar will get rid of the acid. It also helps if you like a sweeter sauce. So now that we have our sauce done, the next step is gonna be throw a little bit of powder down.
make it out nice. Put it back. Take our dough, stretch it out. You wanna go stretch it, flip it, bop it. Stretch it, flip it, bop it. Whip it, bop it, whip it, bop it.
Bump it, twist it, lick it.
You're gonna roll her in the dough. You can be fancy, you can do the whole, whatever it is you like to do. Don't whine if you don't have a rolling pin. Us Italians roll with it. Literally, we're gonna use a wine bottle. To roll out our dough. Right, so gravity is your best friend. Let the pizza pull itself. If for any reason you get any kind of a hole, just pinch it, go with it. So now that we have our dough stretched, we're going to take our pizza paddle. Yeah, big shout out to little Jimmy Caldy from my job who made this because I was too cheap to spend the $12 at Walmart to buy one. We're gonna take flour, most important. You do not want this pizza to stick. So now that the board is all floured up, we're gonna take our pizza, stretch it out to the size of the board, make some round edges. So now we're gonna make a beautiful crust. You can make it as thick or as small as you want. Now that we have our pizza ready with our crust, we're gonna take that beautiful sauce and we're gonna spread her out. So now that my sauce is on my crust, I like to take my grated cheese. And I like to give that a quick hit because grated cheese makes it greater. Now we're gonna take the mozzarella. You can use fresh. I'm working on a budget. Bear with me, all right? Go around lightly. Don't go too heavy on this coat because believe me, baby, we are gonna cheese this up. Now we're gonna take some of that Asiago and we're gonna just crumble it up. This is a strong cheese. You don't want to go too heavy with it, but man, is it delicious on a pizza. Now, we're going to do some pepperonis, and then we're going to hit this baby with the meats. And I know when this is done, you won't be able to resist putting my meat in your mouth. One, two, missed it. Three, missed it. Four. We're going to take our bacon. Try a little, make sure it's good enough. Quality, that's what we're about. We're gonna take that, we're gonna sprinkle all over this pizza. Don't want any of this left because this is magic. And we believe in magic. We're gonna take that beautiful ham and we're gonna sprinkle that over, all over. Don't let any fall off the plate. Find which piece you think you're gonna want. Put more ingredients on that slice. This is all about strategy. Now, if that isn't looking good enough to eat already, I don't know what does. But then we're gonna take that sausage meat and we're gonna hit the top of this, the icing on the cake. If pizza was a cake, they both use dodo. So technically, we're eating cake. Simple logic. Now, that all of that looks beautiful, we're going to wash our hands quick. So after handling so much meat, I need a drink. I'm exhausted. But we're not done. Time for the cheese. We're gonna go all around the pizza with a nice liberal coat of mozzarella. Then we're gonna hit it again with that beautiful Asiago. Don't worry about cross-contamination with cheese. They both stink. Delicious. Now we're gonna take our grater and we're gonna hit the top of that very lightly. I put my ingredients away because I'm dumb, but I forget. Hit it with a little oregano on the top. We're ready for the oven. Now that we've had our oven heated at 500 degrees, our pizza stone has been in there for 1 hour, preheated, it's time to put the meats in. We're gonna use my big fucking spatula to give us a helping hand. And I'ma lose my pizza.
mind. And if I lose this pizza, I'm gonna lose my mind. There we go.
Oven closing. This is gonna take about 15 to 18 minutes or until the crust reaches the desired color you want. I'll see you in a few minutes. All right, guys, round two. The food that my food eats is going on a pizza as well. Do everything I did on the first pizza, just don't add the meat. This is a vegetarian pizza.
In Napoli, where love is king, when boy meets girl, here's what they say.
When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amore. When the world seems to shine like you've had too much wine, that's amore. Bells will ring, ting-a-ling-a-ling, ting-a-ling-a-ling.
And just like that, our pizza is done. In with the other.
Right.
It's been about 18 minutes. We're gonna check on that veggie pizza. She is ready to come out. So we're going to go in and take the whole pizza stone. The beauty. Just, it's beautiful. I can see myself in the camera. No, I'm kidding. We're talking about the pizza. Take a look at this. So we got our meat lovers pizza with three cheese blend, homemade sauce, dough. We got our vegetarian pizza for the people that don't like to eat the meat. We're not friends, but I hope you enjoyed the video anyway. I couldn't do that again if I wanted to. We're gonna cut this right now in half. Nice, crispy, crunchy crust. I'm not even cutting it for everybody else because I just have to take a bite, and you already know. Look at the bottom there. Crunchy, crispy dough. Mamma mia. Delicious. All over my face. Absolutely beautiful. Salty meats. Makes you drink more. What else could you ask for? All I'm gonna say is if you don't like pizza, you can get the fuck out of my kitchen.